I got it. I'll fly.
I'm good. Crank it.
Drone is up.
Looks like they're feeling froggy. I got a narco over here. There, inside the firing post. Roger that. Moving.
Moving to a good sight line.
Copy that. Moving.
Eyes on the target.
Target acquired. Lost visual on the target.
Target marked. Got him. He's down.
Thank you.
one narco. Inside the firing post.
Gunner the Tango.
Unidad Bird approaching. Stay down.
I'm getting a position. I've got the target. Target lost.
Frag out. Get some.
Got a mounted weapon.
All right, breathe easy.
Okay, we're cool.
Sniper up in the tower.
Local news. A construction vehicle has run over Aymara protesters in Agua Verde, resulting in 25 dead and dozens more injured. Since April, the Aymara have been staging marches of resistance, blocking roads in an attempt to prevent construction crews from driving to the construction site of Paraíso Agua Verde, resort and casino. Early this morning, an earth-moving dump truck broke through the protesters, resulting in the deaths. The approved site sits on what has long been considered sacred land. Environmental groups have also expressed concern that pollution from the resort will damage the ecosystem of the lake. No charges have been filed for the deaths, and there is no word yet from Aymara representatives if the protests will continue. Military police from Unidad have moved into the area to ensure order. In international news, Queen Brita of Sweden has given birth to a baby girl.
Get to the next antenna. Clock's ticking.
Buckle up, people.
Let's roll.
Ready? Fire, fire, fire.
I call firing.
Looks like we're rounding them. Their lieutenant's running away.
Nice work. That should keep those Sicarios from sharing rebel positions.
Here they come. What's the play, boss?
fire.
Roger.
Check it out, weapons case. I call the rebels for a diversion. I call Pacatari for some reinforcements. Ah, I could use this. We're good. We all in one piece? These supplies will buy us a lot of goodwill from the rebels.
Coming in. With the back-to-back hits. You know, given our reputation for being villains, you'd think more cartel members would wear black. But whether you're all dudded up like a ranchero chingon, or if you go for the crispy white t-shirt and the 501s with the creased irons all sharp and shit, we usually dress with a little more tan and brown. Sometimes I think it might be easier for me in the morning if we had gang colors.
Deploying drone.
good to go.
All right, we're all clear.
Nice. Anyone up for walking through there?
You know how long it'd take just for our socks to dry off? It does look refreshing. I'll worry about wet socks, all right?
Come on, let's keep moving.
We got hostiles in the area.
I got a target carrying submachine guns. Just spotted one with submachine guns. Move there.
That was fucking close. I think they found their pal.
Frag out. I need you there.
Roger that.
Put a call to the rebels for some reinforcements. I called for rebels to draw their
got
eyes on the captain.
Tangles are marked. Position. Standing by. Drifting too far apart. Moving back. I'm in. Let's go.
Thank you.
Carzita's the cartel's front man, but it's his assistant that keeps the resort running. Take him out, and we'll force Carzita's hand.
Bowman, we're at the location. Carzita's assistant have any identifying characteristics?
Nothing we're 100% on. You should have a few listening devices in your loadout. Try bugging some of the areas where a lot of the VIPs hang out. One of them could give us the assistant's location. I'll call you when we hear something. And remember, the bugs won't be worth shit if they spot you.
Stay out of sight, people. Plant the bugs and diddy mal. Don't even cast a shadow. That car's got an alarm. I got a target carrying submachine guns. God damn, that was close.
Hey, we got a narco with a submachine gun by the building entrance.
Drone is up.
Roger that. Moving. Roger. Target acquired.
target number 5.
Bugs are in place. They should pick up enough dirt for Bowman to get the location on Carzita's assistant. Let's make like a tree and get the fuck out.
Carzita's assistant is as popular as a JV cheerleader on the pill. The Bugs picked up a guest mentioning where he is. I'm sending you the location now.
Tango Mike.
Don't waste any time with this guy. Just kill him and be done with it.
Roger that. Nomad out.
I'm moving to position. Let me find a good position.
Shit, I gotta find a good position.
Target marked.
Target acquired.
Say the word.
Hey, we're good.
Let's go.
I'm in. Let's roll.
Lieutenant's trying to escape. Ready? Fire, fire, fire.
Copy that. Engaging tangos.
He's dead.
Tabacal province. What can you tell us?
Tabacal was once a major coffee producer, but over the last few years, Santa Blanca has forced the coffee growers to become cocoleros instead, growing leaf exclusively for the cartel.
Who's our target?
A cartel boss named Madre Coca. The cocoleros are terrified of her. Take a look at the video I just sent and you'll understand why. She runs Tabacal like her own mini cartel. Production of coca leaf, distribution by truck and train, and enough security to keep the cocoleros in line and the convoy secure. All of it run with ruthless efficiency. I'm in contact with a small group of rebels. They're willing to help us fight the cartel if we can prove our good intentions.
You got any suggestions?
Two things you can do to earn their trust. First, an old cocolero named Chavez has been trying to get the farmers to stand up to the cartel. Word is he's giving a speech to the cocoleros at the agricultural cooperative. Make contact with him there and keep him safe.
What else?
Supposedly, the cartel collects their coca in this province from a single farm. Ambush the cartel when they come for the coca. That should send a message to the cocoleros and disrupt Madre Coca's production.
Ruperta Faro, Madre Coca. They used to grow coffee here in Tabacal, but the cartels made them switch to coca. A lot more profitable. If you ever tried to snort Italian roast, you'll know why. Spoiler alert, this is frowned upon at coffee shops. Don't ask. Madre Coca grew up as a raspicina, a coca picker. When it comes to illegal coca farms, there's no such thing as child labor laws. It was brutal, backbreaking work. She had a son whom she'd always dreamed would move on to better things. He didn't. Young Pablo died from a coke overdose. How does a mother who grows coca deal with growing the product that killed her own kid? Most people see the error of their ways and move on to something else. For Madre Coca, it was the exact opposite. She took out her anger on the people of Tabacal, forcing them to endure the same hardship she had experienced. And like any tyrant, she expanded her empire. This led to resentment from the people, which she dealt with. With the backing of El Yeyo, she became a very powerful woman in the cartel. A new twist on an age-old lesson. You don't fuck with Mama.
Bowman, this is Nomad. What have you got on Media Luna?
That province is all Unidad. A thug in uniform calling himself El Comandante is considered top dog out there. He's assisting Santa Blanca with security, especially against the rebels. We have to break up this little romance between Unidad and Santa Blanca, but since El Comandante always wears a mask, we have no idea who he is.
We'll look into that mystery for you and see if we can't make things uncomfortable for Santa Blanca along the way.
Intel on this guy is sketchy at best. The cartel and the Bolivians call him El Comandante. Age unknown, birthplace unknown, real name unknown. An officer in Unidad, Bolivia's military police, El Comandante made a name for himself hunting down rebels. The rebels had something of a foothold in Media Luna until El Comandante and Unidad arrived in force. It was a slaughter. Rumor has it our boy personally took a few scalps as souvenirs. On paper, he's a lieutenant colonel. In reality, he wields the kind of authority reserved for legends. And he's been using that authority to put Unidad to work for Santa Blanca. But the way he's been insinuating Unidad into the cartel's operation should make Sueño worry. If it were up to him, Sueño wouldn't work with anyone from Unidad. His problem is the rebels. You can't fight what you don't know. And if there's one thing El Comandante knows, it's the rebels. Without him, Media Luna would be in rebel-controlled territory. Like all good frenemies, Sueño keeps a close eye on El Comandante, careful never to let down his guard.
Thank you.
on a narco with a submachine gun. Over by the turret. Heads up, we got a turret.
Just spotted one with submachine guns.
I need to get to a better position. Target acquired. Standing by.
Targets.
That guy's history.
Keep it quiet. They know we're here. Their LT is trying to run. Got the bike.
Ready to fire. Okay. Looks like they're settling down over there. Enemy reinforcements coming in. Down troops are moving in. Grenade, get to cover.
I requested a vehicle from the rebels.
Here's your right, compadre.
Grenade, move!
Open fire.
Roger. Opening fire on these fuckers.
Nomad, the activity's just intercepted a call. You caused enough trouble that Carzito's back in Aqua Verde. He's gonna throw a party every day of the week. He's hoping to convince people that things are all right.
Where's the party?
His place. Crash it. Make him give up that guest list.
That's exactly what I had in mind. Nomad out. The assistant is down. I say again, the assistant is down.
Won't be long till Carzita has to come handle his business personally.